What's up, everybody? It's Shu Flocka back at it again with another Madden YouTube video. Today we have another top 10. This is the brand new series, so we're going to be seeing a lot of reduxes, so a lot of these guys will be very obtainable. This is going to be the wide receiver top 10, so make sure to drop a like if you guys really do enjoy these top 10s, because these will keep me going. I really do enjoy making these, so make sure to drop a like. Anyways, let's head into number 10. Number 10, we do actually have the brand new Courtland Sutton here. I actually think this card is very solid, and the reason why I have him over guys like DK Metcalf or all those other guys, he really has the same height as them. He's one speed lower than them, but he does have that power up. But his route running is insane on this card, and he's go get it guy because he is very tall. All his catch and traffic stats are very good. He's also a physical archetype. I honestly think he plays very good as well. I did pick him up for almost 300k yesterday. So I bought him for around 295k yesterday. And that was an insane pickup for an LTD. As you guys know, this guy is very common on the market and in very down in price right now because he is pullable out of a 2000 training pack. But this guy is super solid. I just don't even know what to say about him. He's a really good receiver. Plays a lot better than his archetype would say he does. He does have great stats. If this was a different archetype wide receiver, he'd be in the top five. That's how good his stats really are. But we do have him at number 10 just because of that archetype. But let's head into number 9. At number 9, we do have this DeSean Jackson. He did just get a redux today, so he is looking very, very fire. He has a 96 overall, or a 96 speed, my fault. He has a 96 overall as well. He does not have a power up, but he's still very fast, just base. We are hoping he gets a power up soon with Kralo just announcing this morning that we will be getting power up soon. So DeSean Jackson is one of them we do need. That will even maybe boost him up higher, being a 99 speed receiver. But he is very solid. As you guys can see, his route running is very good. A big deep threat, 96 deep route running as well. Just an all-around solid card, a very fast guy. This guy was, you never saw him because of how expensive he is. Now he has a redux sitting around 350k right now to 400k. He probably will go down in price too. This is being recorded literally an hour after these reduxes came out. But DeSean Jackson, a great card to have and a great wide receiver in the game. But let's head into our number 8. But number 8, we do have Steve Smith here. He is 95 speed and also has a power up, but I don't know what it is about this card. I am not going based off stats. I'm also going based off of gameplay and what I've seen from him. And also, his value is crazily terrible. He is sitting around 900k right now, and also his, a 5'9 receiver, when we have other receivers with the similar stats like this that are also route runners, it's just like, he's still top 10. He's easily, he could be moved up a tiny bit. He could be moved down a tiny bit. It really comes down to, he is a 5'9 receiver that is a deep threat that has the same stats as other wide receivers. It really does kill him in the long run. But it's still a solid card. I'm pretty sure he does get playmaker as well. So he is a very, very solid card. It just comes down to the value at 900k for a card that's not even in the top 5. It makes people not even want to touch him. And that's why you never see him on the field, actually. But it's still a top 10 receiver. It just comes down to, are you going to pay 900k for him? But let's head into number 7. But number 7, we do have T.Y. Hilton here. He is pretty much what I was comparing Steve Smith to. You can see a 95 base speed with the power, with great route running. The catching isn't the best at 89 catch in traffic, but it's still doable, especially with go deep on him. But he is a route runner, which makes him better. And he's also, I mean, 5'10 isn't the crazy. It's definitely not a crazy height or anything. But when you're a route runner, it does accelerate you overall. This is a car that's 2 overalls lower and 800k cheaper. So from a value standpoint, T.Y. Hilton is obviously better. But then again, when you're looking at Steve Smith, he is, I don't know how to explain it. He is a deep threat. He can be very good in situations. He is a top 10 receiver, no doubt. It just has, T.Y. is just better than him. And he's 2 overalls low. Just because of an archetype, that really is what's killing it at this moment. And availability for that price range, T.Y. Hilton 100% is the guy I would take. But anyways, let's head into number 6. Number 6, we do have Stephon Diggs here, another route runner right here. The reason I have him above T.Y., although he has a minus one speed from T.Y., he does get that wide receiver playmaker. His route running's a tiny bit better, and also the catching is a lot better than T.Y.'s. It really comes down to that height, and also he does get wide receiver playmaker, which is one of the best abilities in the game. If you guys aren't using it, it really does kill one step ahead, and man, you just got to be able to use it. It takes a while to learn it and truly get used to it. But Stephon Diggs, easily a top 6 receiver in this game, a very solid player and also is a route runner archetype. So a guy that you could probably see on a lot of teams for a while in this game. Start our top five right here. We do have Santana Moss right here, a slot-o-matic receiver. You guys know he gets slot-o-matic for cheap because he is that slot archetype. 95 base speed with a power-up. He is a little expensive because I think that set was expensive to do, but you could probably complete the set, get his power-up and him for a lot cheaper than you can buy them both on the market for. His route running is good. The catching is very good. You still see a lot of people using this guy to this day because of how good he is, and he was ahead of his time when he came out. A slot receiver with these stats and that speed was way ahead of his time, and also goes in one of the best theme teams in the game, which is Washington Football Team. Easily one of the top tier theme teams and easily a top tier receiver to put inside of it. Not bad at all. Let's move on to our number four. Number four, we do have Tyreek Hill here, a 97 base speed wide receiver. You don't even have to power him up to get him into a 99 speed. This is one where our top three to top four guys are all very interchangeable. And I honestly, you can make a case for him being number one. You can make a case for him being four. So I really think Tyreek Hill and these next guys are very, very good. It just comes down to, I really think you do need route tech on your guys. And being at 3 AP right now for wide receiver at Tyreek Hill. And there's also other guys above him who can get a 99 speed that does have better archetypes. That's why I think Tyreek's a little lower on this list. But the route running's insane. The catching is even really good for a Tyreek. He is also a 99 base. You don't even got to power him up. But I do suggest powering up so you can get all those other stats really high. Just an easy, easy dub for a team. And I'll see a lot of 97 power passes on him. Hopefully you guys use him on other players as well, like Derrick Henry. But this Tyreek is a really, really good player to add to your team. But anyways, let's head into our top three. Number three, we do have Isaac Bruce here, the brand new ultimate legend. 95 base speed, 6 foot, gets wide receiver playmaker, also has crazy, crazy route running, all 94 plus, even 95 plus with a power up. The catching's insane, all 96 plus actually, and also is a route runner. There's not much to say about this guy. He also gets wide receiver playmaker. I don't know if I already said that, but you guys can see right here, he's an all-around great receiver. And also a very fun receiver too. He's just a little expensive right now because ultimate legends are kind of impossible to pull. But I truly do think this guy will come down in price. You'll see him on a lot of teams just because of how good his stats purely are and how good of a receiver he actually is. And also is a 6 foot route runner. You don't really see that often. So not bad at all for Isaac Bruce. He is our number three today. Let's head into our two. So at our number two position, we do have Randy Moss here, a base speed 95 wide receiver, and also he is 6'4 with these crazy route running. Also has a power up a tad bit expensive, but everybody knows Randy Moss is one of those cards that just play better than his stats. That height, he does really moss people a lot of the times. He'll get stuck in those aggro animations and come down with it. He also kills press. I don't know what it is. Randy Moss is just a guy I feel like I need on my team every single year, no matter what kind of card they give him. This guy has honestly been that guy for me on my team, and I don't think I'll ever get rid of him. He has 99 speed on my team because I am in a Raiders theme team. So Randy Moss on my team really is just, I feel like he's easily a top three receiver in this game. Like I said, the top four kind of interchangeable for me, but Randy Moss, I don't know, everybody knows he's kind of like that Bo Jackson, kind of like that Mike Vick. No matter what you do to him, they'll always be playable and be good in the game. Kind of what you could see here with Randy Moss. He will always be good despite being that deep threat archetype. He is still amazing. Can get route tech for 3 AP, not the best, but he's still really, I don't know. I don't know if he truly needs it because of how big he is, and he does still beat man a lot. But at the end of the day, everybody knows how good Randy is. But let's finally head into our top one position of this video. At number one in this video, I do have Terry McLaurin here. He did just get a redux, but he's one of those guys you could power up and not even have a theme team and get him to a 99 speed. The route running will be all 95 plus after the power up as well. Catching's insane, gets wide receiver playmaker, also is 6 foot. He does not have route running on him, but I think this is a guy you can spare 3 AP on just because of how good he truly is. Like I said, a 99 speed receiver with great catching stats, great route running, and also gets wide receiver playmaker. This is why you guys saw every single pro in the MCS using this card. He really is that good of a wide receiver. And honestly, I could see him being on my team for almost the rest of the year. We'll see on that, but Terry McLaurin, a very fun card to use as well, but I truly, truly do love him on my team. Hope you guys go get him as well. This is my number one for the video. Make sure to let me know who you guys would change in and out of the video, who you guys would move in and out of the list. And remember to drop a like. It really does help me out with the algorithm. I'll see you guys in the next video. We'll probably be doing a pack opening in the morning tomorrow for the new Ultimate Legends. I'll see you guys then. Peace out, boys.